I All right, here we go, friends. Ready?
Really?
Oh, Graduates, please be seated. At this time, I ask that senior singers please begin to make your way over to the risers. Good morning, graduates and guests. At this time, I ask that you please rise for the presentation of colors presented by United States Vietnam veterans, Sergeant Butch Jensen and Petty Officer Third Class John Dayton, representing the Nathan Hale VFW Post 1469. Please be seated. Good morning and welcome to the 59th commencement exercises for the Cold Spring Harbor High School. We join together to celebrate the achievements of the class of 2022. My name is Daniel Dambusky, and I have the distinct privilege of serving as principal for this outstanding group of young men and women. It is my pleasure to introduce the guests seated with us, as well as those seated in the audience. I ask that you please hold your applause until everyone has been introduced. President of the Board of Education, Mrs. Amelia Walsh Brogan. Vice President of the Board of Education, Dr. Janice Elkins. Trustees of the Board of Education, Mrs. Tara Belfi, Mr. Mark Friedberg, Mrs. Heather Morante Young, Mrs. Tammy Stark, and Mrs. Julie Starr. The Superintendent of Schools, Ms. Jill Girosh. The Deputy Superintendent, Mr. James Stuccio. The Assistant Superintendent for Counseling, Student Services, and Human Resources, Mrs. Mona Hecht. The Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum and Instruction, Mrs. Genevieve Lagatuda. The Executive Director of Instructional and Administrative Technology, Mr. Joseph Monastero. The Executive Director of Special Education and Pupil Personnel Services, Dr. Tina Smith. Director of Humanities, Mrs. Karen Moser. Assistant Director of Special Education and Pupil Personnel Services, Mrs. Kristen Raska. District Chairperson of Music, Mr. Brent Chiarella. District Chairperson of Art, Ms. Christine Oswald. District Chairperson of World Languages, Ms. Sandra Rivadeneira. The Assistant Principals for the Junior Senior High School, Mr. Jason Huntsman and Mrs. Caitlin Coffey Harmon. Choral Director, Mr. Mark Bezier. We also welcome many members of our staff and our faculty who are here to support our students. Certainly, without your endless efforts over the last 4 years, the accomplishments of the students before you would not be possible. I would like to say thank you very much to the teachers who are here today. Also present are three very important members of our staff who have worked tirelessly to assist in preparation for today's ceremony. I see them kind of hiding in the back, but I want to bring attention to them. They're the main office administrative assistants, Mrs. Ann Connell, Mrs. Patricia Lynch, and Mrs. Denise Vigilo. Students, graduates from the class of 2022, I ask that you now take this opportunity to thank the distinguished guests who are here with you on this rainy morning. Those would be your parents, your grandparents, your family, and friends. So please show your appreciation for your support networks. I don't know how I feel about that. Can we try that again? Thank you. I like the enthusiasm. Before I present the class of 2022 to the Board of Education for the confirmative diplomas, I would like to take an opportunity to say a few words to this exceptional class of young men and women. However, what does a principal share with a group of graduation candidates as they prepare to embark in their post-secondary career after 2 years living through a global pandemic that has literally impacted every facet of their lives? I bet I know what you're thinking, graduates. Please don't put me to sleep right now, and please don't give me a speech about resilience. I will do my best not to do either of those things. The truth is, as the students who are going to speak today will tell you, that writing a commencement address is a difficult task. I've been to quite a few commencement ceremonies over the course of my career, and just last year, I was able to observe my first formal graduation ceremony as a parent when my daughter graduated from eighth grade. The ceremony left me truly inspired. It really was the sweetest thing because all of the teachers from the eighth grade team came up on stage and serenaded the class with a beautiful rendition of Don't Stop Believing. It was really heartwarming and the kids really enjoyed it. So I was thinking, how great would it be if I serenaded the class with Don't Stop Believing? Unfortunately, I can't sing Happy Birthday without making people cry, so I will not be serenading you. By the way, moms, dads, a decision for which you should be eternally grateful. There are very few important takeaways from this ceremony that I witnessed, the most important of which was a reaffirmation of something I said to you all during graduation rehearsal the other day. Yes, we're here at graduation to recognize and celebrate your accomplishments, but the ceremony's not really for you. The ceremony is for the support network that helped you along the way, your parents, your family, your friends, your grandparents, the people who have supported you throughout this journey. The truth is, graduates, you have no idea the sense of pride that those people are going to feel in a few short moments when you walk across this stage, and you probably won't recognize it until you're sitting in their seats watching your children walk across the stage of graduation. My daughter inspired me after this ceremony. A recent interaction with her really helped me nail down what I wanted to share with you today. She celebrated her 15th birthday recently, and I asked her where she wanted to go for dinner. And her response was, "What are my choices?" This led me to the unfortunate realization that apparently my daughter was completely incapable of formulating an original idea. I wondered who I should blame. Maybe she took too many multiple choice tests in school. Was I at fault because I didn't spend enough time going over all the menus from the only three restaurants that are on Main Street in our town? Or was it simply because she was focused on the answer? When I look back on it, there was definitely a hesitation about her response, like she was afraid of not having the right answer. The light bulb went off. This is what I want to share with you today. Do not live life as a checkoff list focused on getting the right answers. Don't get me wrong, it's important to be right, but not when it comes at the cost of your development. Please understand, learning is a process. Enjoy that process. Immerse yourself, engulf yourself with that process. If I were to stand here today and speak to you about your future in a checklist pattern, it may sound something like this. You are here on graduation day. For many of you, the next 5 years, you will have completed your collegiate studies and will have started your careers. Within a few years, you may get married, perhaps buy a home, and perhaps start a family of your own. For some of you, in 10 years' time, you will be working full-time and your life will be set for you. Before you know it, you will be 30 and your life will be fully planned through retirement. Does anybody else feel a little stressed hearing that? Right? Because what am I focusing on? I'm focusing on the destination. Right? Don't focus on the destination. Focus on the process. Focus on the process or your approach may fail you. I know a lot of people who have graduated college with MBAs and couldn't find a job for 6 years. I know people who graduated at 22 and walked into the job of their dreams. I know people who never went to college but found something that they are passionate about and they enjoy every single moment of their lives. I also know people who found great jobs, making great money, and absolutely hate what they do for a living. You may look at some of your friends right now and think they're ahead of you, or perhaps you might think you're ahead of them. Don't fall into that trap. Recognize everybody has their own timeline. Everybody has their own process. Famous physicist Neil deGrasse Tyson once told a story about being able to think outside the box and focus on the process. He gave an example of two job candidates showing up in Washington, D.C. for a job with the United States government. The first question was asked, "What is the height of the spire on the top of this building?" The candidate responded by rattling off that he minored in architecture and he had memorized all of the features of the buildings in Washington, and he knows that that spire is exactly 153 feet tall. Turns out he was correct. The second candidate came in and was posed the same question. His answer was, "No, I don't know, but I'll be right back." With that, he ran outside and he measured the length of the shadow of the spire. He then measured his own shadow. He then conducted a ratio to determine that it was 156 feet. Even though the process took longer, that person knew how to use his mind in a different way. He finished the story by telling the audience that when you know how to think, it empowers you far beyond knowing merely what to think. There are no shortage of examples out there professionally who personify the importance of focusing on the process and continually growing as a result. Perhaps we could look at Mark Cuban, owner of the Dallas Mavericks, who at the age of 25 was a bartender in Dallas. J.K. Rowling, who was rejected by 12 publishing companies prior to being able to sign Harry Potter at the age of 32. The actor Morgan Freeman, who landed his breakthrough role at the age of 52. What do all of these people have in common? They focused on the process, the journey, and they continually grew as a result. I know that we're here at your graduation, and everyone is excited for the day and the summer to start and to go on vacation and for college to be there. And you have the right to be excited. You've had the job of being a high school student for the last 4 years, and some of you may be focused on taking some time off. That's fine, but please don't ever stop learning. If you stop learning, all of those people you think you're ahead of will pass you by. I urge you to remember, graduation is called commencement, which means beginning. These are your first steps. The journey cannot end simply because the mission has been accomplished. Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos, arguably one of our most impressive modern-day innovators, signs his annual shareholder letter with the same cryptic message every year. It remains day one. After years of doing this, somebody asked him why he wrote that at the end of the letter. He explained that day two would mean stasis, followed by irrelevance and excruciatingly painful decline. Therefore, it must always remain day one. Graduation candidates, it is my sincere wish that you let every day after today remain day one. And if you do, the possibilities will be endless. Let it remain day one. Graduation candidates, as you prepare to join the ranks of Cold Spring Harbor alumni, I hope your dreams have been realized and they have come alive for you. As you leave us, I charge you to find problems that need to be solved, rethink solutions, and allow the journey to help shape you as you mature. Remember that long-term satisfaction comes from solving problems and serving people, implementing lots of hard work, delayed gratification, and above all, sacrifice. Do not be afraid to embrace what you don't know, but rather recognize the power that lies within that paradigm. If there's anything we learned from the last 2 years, it's that flexibility and adaptability are underrated. You entered our school as young, curious children, but you leave here today as mature, confident young men and women. We, the staff of Cold Spring Harbor Junior Senior High School, have had the honor of witnessing your growth academically, socially, and emotionally, and we stand in awe of your accomplishments. Through all you have accomplished during your high school years, you have contributed greatly to the learning community that is Cold Spring Harbor High School, and you have left a legacy for those who will follow in your footsteps. There is a very strong bond that unites all of you as you've grown together as a class, celebrating wonderful achievements and events, and enduring some of the most difficult and challenging moments of your lives. As a class, you have distinguished yourself through academic excellence, athletic achievements and accomplishments in art and music, and through countless acts of service to the school community and the community at large. Throughout your years at Cold Spring Harbor High School, you have challenged the boundaries of excellence and consistently succeeded in raising the bar for yourselves and for the students who will follow. Your amazing energy and spirit will definitely be missed here at Cold Spring Harbor High School. We thank you for your contributions to our great school community, and I would like to say congratulations on all of your outstanding accomplishments. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce our first student speaker to share his reflections with the class of 2022. Please join me in welcoming to the microphone Thomas Sekaritis.
Before I begin, I'd like to thank Mr. Dan Buskey and the rest of the administration, the Board of Ed, and the class of 2022. When I was getting ready to write this speech, I was talking to my girlfriend, and she said, "Please, whatever you do, just don't embarrass yourself." Unfortunately for her, embarrassing myself is the only skill I've mastered. Freshman year, brand new to the school, significantly chubbier than I am now, knowing absolutely no one except my cousin Fraser and my brother Hank, I thought it'd be a brilliant idea to dye my hair green. That went about as well as expected. Even Dr. Bolin made fun of me. At six, my favorite television program was Nova, the PBS science show for old people. At 12, I liked to wear cargo shorts and Minecraft t-shirts. Perhaps most humiliating is just how much of an edgy teenager I've been over the past 4 years. I've written crappy poetry and cringy music, made stupid decisions, said stupid things, the works. I was an idiot. And while I don't think I'm an idiot now, I hope a year from now I will. See, embarrassment is fundamentally a good thing. If you don't cringe at the person you were a year ago, even a few months ago, that means you're not growing. You haven't improved. As we look back on our high school years, we should be cringing at ourselves. A lot. And if you aren't, it might mean you haven't learned anything, or you haven't lived your life. Make it your mission in college to risk embarrassment. Embrace humiliation. Revel in tomfoolery. Take both work and fun seriously. Lose yourself in everything you do, and happiness will be yours. As the philosopher Pyotr Kropotkin said, variety is life. Uniformity is death. Don't pay any mind to people cringing at you. Cringing at yourself is the only feeling that matters. Now, all of that sounded really clever when I was writing it, but just yesterday I was reading my speech to my dad and he stopped me and said, "Didn't Taylor Swift say something like that?" Apparently, Taylor Swift mentioning embracing cringe at a speech at NYU, so I guess we have something in common, which I must admit I find incredibly cringe. But whatever. I'm 17. I don't know anything about anything. I've got long hair, and just a few months ago, black nail polish was a staple of my school outfit. My judgment abilities are clearly still evolving. But God willing, all of us have a good many years ahead of us to get better. So let's all just be as cringy and weird as we want. Let's welcome embarrassment, because it's an inevitable byproduct of a fulfilling life. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you, Thomas. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce our first graduate performance, performing the climb for the class of 2022. Please welcome Caroline Coyne.
See it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just gotta keep going, and I gotta be strong. Just keep pushing on, 'cause there's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. Gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. Keep on moving, keep climbing, keep the faith, baby. It's all about the climb. Keep the faith, keep your faith.
Thank you so much, Caroline. At this time, our second student speaker to share his reflections with the class of 2022, please join me in welcoming to the podium, Michael Keschner.
Good morning. Thank you, Mr. Dambusky, and welcome to Mr. Huntsman, Ms. Coffey, Mrs. Brogan, Board of Ed members, parents, grandparents, siblings, and members of the class of 2022. Please allow me to introduce myself. I am Michael Keschner, and for the past 4 years, I have had the honor and privilege of serving my class as their student council president. Graduations are special occasions where one chapter ends and another begins. It's a memorable day filled with excitement, maybe some relief, and most definitely pride. We have turned in our textbooks, signed yearbooks, and said goodbye to underclassmen friends, staff members, and teachers. Graduations are often the time to look back while simultaneously looking forward. We have achieved a lot as a class. Sitting amongst us are National Merit Scholars, award-winning thespians, all-state musicians, debate and robotic champions, and college-bound athletes. Yet with all of our accomplishments, it is unlikely anyone sitting up here will be the quarterback for the Jets. They will not find the cure for cancer, nor will it is likely that we'll have the prima ballerina for the New York Ballet. Of course, we will try to achieve such, and we can help change the world by standing up for what is right. So, my amazing and unique classmates, now is the time to challenge ourselves, to see beyond the confines of our comfortable community, acknowledge the complexities of the world, take action in creating our legacy, and make the world a better place. So when a World War II veteran has to stand in line at a food pantry because he can't afford food, stand up. When the N-word is used casually in conversations, we need to stand up. When someone carves a swastika at our town's beach, stand up. When an 18-year-old walks into an elementary school and kills 19 students, we need to stand up. When people are being bullied and tormented for how they vote and who they love, stand up. You get my point. Find a purpose, align yourself with doing good. Choose life-affirming actions, possess personal accountability. Can you imagine the kind of influence we could have as class if we all stood up? Our unique and amazing gifts, our interests and passions, coupled with this new commitment to taking action, would leave a profound collective impact on humanity. This is how we, as Cold Spring Harbor alumni, will together change the world. So today, as we transition from students to alumni, we share the profound gratitude for the education, extracurricular experiences, and tremendous opportunities our Cold Spring Harbor years have provided. We thank our teachers for teaching us, our guidance counselors for guiding us, and of course, our parents for parenting us. Our Cold Spring Harbor roots are deeply embedded. We are Seahawks who are ready to fly. So let's soar high with pride from where we came from and use our actions to make the world a better place. Congratulations, class of 2022.
For our second performance, it's my pleasure to introduce a duet, Matthew Hustava and Andrew Neuhead performing Fly Me to the Moon.
Hold on to this one. Once he's ready.
Hello.
Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter, Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you. in other words, please be true. In other words, in other words, I love you.
Thank you, Matthew and Andrew. At this time, it's my privilege to introduce, under the direction of choir director Mark Beja, the senior high school choir.
You travel on, when there's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door, where the world won't hurt you anymore. Where the murmurs free and the lovers soar, come round with me to the distant shore.
Wait, you're gonna come down, down and up, that way, come across and then out. Come across and then down. Come across and then down. Come across.
Thank you, Mr. Beja, and the choir. For our final student speaker this morning, please join me in welcoming to share her reflections with the class of 2022, Sarah Kiefer.
Teachers, administrators, staff, family, and friends, we did it. We collectively all share in the success of today and all it represents. We entered this school 6 years ago as seventh graders and as very different people than we all are today. We were fresh out of elementary school with feelings of fear and excitement. Fear of what was going to be expected of us in junior high and in high school. Fear we wouldn't have our friends in our classes or worse during our lunch period. Fear of the grown bearded men walking the halls that were students and not faculty. Fear we wouldn't be able to meet all the expectations academically or socially. And specifically for me, that I was too shy and not quick enough to assimilate to new surroundings and my best wouldn't be good enough. All those fears seemed so monumental, but thankfully I received some great advice early on. I didn't think it was great advice at the time, but I realized while preparing this speech how often I reflected on this advice, and I know it helped to shape who I am today and who I plan to be in the future. The simple advice was this: be true to yourself, trust your instincts, and do the right thing, even when it's hard to do so. And most of all, have faith. To an incoming seventh grader, this was not great advice. Junior and senior high meant more freedom, independence, parties, events, and school sports teams. All the possibilities were exciting and new. Seventh grade is either a great year for you or the worst year. There is so much change so quickly that there's a sink or swim mentality. At least that's how I thought about it. Eighth grade is tapering off a sense of understanding of what is expected and the challenges how to meet those expectations. In 10th grade, the COVID-19 pandemic hit and all we thought we knew changed forever. Friendships, classes, tests, events, and socialization were upended, and we entered into a new normal. It's pretty ironic to look back and realize the advice I dismissed as unrelatable, out of touch, unrealistic, are the very words that guided me through the many decisions I had to make. Through many of our experiences in the Cold Spring Harbor junior-senior high school, especially through the pandemic, I'm sure we all had our own struggles. Some may have been obvious, and some may not have been. We all experienced great loss, loss in so many forms, seen and unseen. But through it, we have become stronger. Whether through words of wisdom, support of friends, family, and teachers who helped us through the tough times, we all realized we are all capable of overcoming the bad times and succeeding if we are true to ourselves, trust your instincts, do the right thing, even when it's hard to do so, and most of all, have faith. So I say to my fellow seniors, graduates, be true to yourself. Reflect on your strengths and weaknesses and embrace them both, because acknowledging and working on them both will make you stronger, more compassionate towards others and their weaknesses, and ultimately a better person. Make no mistake, you will have to put in time and effort. You will have to rely on others, and you will have to stumble. But in the end, you will be better for it. So thank you to all the teachers I've had, and a sincere thank you to my friends for their compassion and kindness, and for all the laughs and great memories. Last but not least, I want to thank my family, my mom, my dad, my sisters, Taylor and Ella, for all their words of advice that I will carry as my anchor in all I plan and hope to accomplish in college and in life. We are the next generation, and we can continue to do better together.
Thank you, Sarah. At this time, please join me in welcoming to the podium to share remarks with our graduation candidates, our Superintendent of Schools, Ms. Jill Girosh.
Good morning, everyone. I ask that you join me in showing your appreciation to Mr. Dambusky, Mr. Huntsman, Mrs. Coffey, and our facilities and security team for seamlessly coordinating this ceremony. Thank you so much. Members of the Board of Education, parents, staff, administrators, teachers, cherished guests, and most importantly, members of the class of 2022. I am honored to be part of this ceremony as you are my first class of graduating seniors as the new superintendent in Cold Spring Harbor this year. I could not be more pleased with your success and sharing your journey with you. This community is indeed about family. In an attempt to find inspiration for my remarks today, I consulted with one of my go-to people, my 28-year-old nephew, Robert. He suggested the book called Make Your Bed by Admiral William McGraven, which both of us have used for inspiration from time to time. The book includes 10 principles that the Admiral learned during Navy SEAL training that helped him overcome challenges, not only in his training and long naval career, but throughout his life. They are basic lessons, and if followed, could help guide you through some of the challenges you may face in the days and years ahead, and likely help you make an impact on the world for the better. I have selected a few of the stories and principles that more closely align with the values of this community, and ones I believe the adults here today could attest to. The easiest one, which takes less than 2 minutes, even if done exceptionally well, is making your bed. I can already see some of the eye rolling on some of the students. I want you to think about this. If you make your bed every morning, you will already have accomplished one of the first tasks of the day. The simple task could give you a small sense of comfort as you walk out the door to start your day. More importantly, when the day didn't go as expected, and perhaps you struggled or failed at something, you will come home, back to your room or home, and notice you made your bed. It will reinforce that you did do something correct, and perhaps give you the reinforcement you need to get out back out there tomorrow. I think you have already started learning the second one. You can't change the world alone. When you look around at the people who were here today, teachers, family, and friends, those who helped you get from your starting point to this destination of graduating, if honest, you will know that it took a strong team, a team of people that you needed to rely on from time to time. For those of you who have been in my office, you'll notice I have this affinity for Little Red Wagons. They're a constant reminder of my family vacations as a child, where we would gather everything we needed for our week at the beach and board the ferry with supplies high on our little red wagons. But those wagons are also a reminder that sometimes you may be tired, worn down, and need a little help. You may need to be in the red wagon and require the help of someone to pull you along for a little while you can get back on your feet to finish your journey. Other times, you will need to pull someone else along and have to work harder and support those around you. Remember not to complain. The wheels can be turned very unexpectedly. Surround yourself, as many of you did here in Cold Spring Harbor, with a strong team. Leave out the I and go for the we. Be an upstander. You have been hearing this message since your early elementary years. In this difficult world which you are about to enter, the message is even more important. Choose your friends and acquaintances carefully. Don't be taken in by someone who's kind, generous, and respectful only to you. Watch how they treat others, and then decide their place in your heart and in your life. Continue to be courageous, as I have witnessed through your participation and work in the Natural Helpers Club, Students Against Destructive Decisions, Locks of Love, on the stage, on the field, and court, and in our community, and for some of you, your individual outreach to me. Courage to face adversity and the unpopular is within all of us. Dig deep, and you will find it in abundance. The power of hope. Think about the power of one person, a Mandela, Lincoln, Parks, King, Mother Teresa, or even a Cold Spring Harbor graduate like Kira Freiberg, Thomas Zacharides, Michael Keschner, Sarah Bolton, Jackson Polo, or Angela Pavlakis. Like them, find that clear path. Think about the steps of your desired outcome and follow through. Look for role models who have found solutions or who have already overcome tremendous adversity. Many of those role models are here with us today. Perform acts of kindness. Doing acts of kindness can have a drastic effect on your mood or outlook, as many of you have already discovered. Small acts of kindness done repeatedly have the power to change another person's outlook. And I would dare to say that Mr. Homer had that impact on all of us, sharing this genuine kindness and outreach. Follow in his footsteps and your bucket will be filled in abundance. If you could give a round of applause for Mr. Homer, who's retiring. Lastly, be kind to yourself. Stop judging yourself so harshly. Love and appreciate your own unique beauty. And remember, sometimes all it takes is one person to make a difference for so many. Graduates, somehow you've managed to balance your quest for academic excellence with equal zeal for making a difference, locally and globally. Class of 2022, you have worked together to leave your mark on the Cold Spring Harbor community. Remember, the next part of your journey shapes you and who you will become. The effort and the things you learn along the way, and more importantly, the people you surround yourself with, will make all the difference in your life that you create for yourself. And as Admiral McGraven said, start each day with a task completed. Please make your bed. Find someone to help you through life. Respect everyone. Know that life is not fair and that you will fail often. But if you take some risk, step up when times are toughest, face down the bullies, lift up those less fortunate, and never ever give up, if you do these things, then you too can change your life for the better. On behalf of the administrative team, faculty, staff, and the Board of Education of this proud Cold Spring Harbor School District, we wish you all the best. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Thank you, Ms. Girosh. At this time, it is my privilege to introduce the President of the Board of Education, Mrs. Amelia Walsh Brogan, to share her thoughts with the class of 2022.
Good morning. On behalf of the entire Cold Spring Harbor Board of Education, it is my pleasure to welcome our administrators, distinguished faculty and staff, and most importantly, our graduating seniors, families, and friends. The class of 2022 has been inspirational in so many ways. We are proud of your strength and courage, your fortitude. You deserve the recognition and acknowledgement of the hard work it took to get to this point. The accolades for all of your accomplishments, whether it be in the theater, the arts, in music, service work, on the athletic fields, or in the classrooms. As I look at the class of 2022, it reminds me how far we have come. In September 2009, you were 5-year-olds boarding the bus for your first day of kindergarten, with your parents watching anxiously and snapping pictures, some of whom were using the new iPhone 3GS, which was just released. Now fast forward 13 years, and I am looking out at a class of young adults ready to show the world what they can do. What's even more impressive is the growth that has taken place inside each and every one of you. You have grown in intelligence, wisdom, integrity, and creativity. You have learned to make hard choices. For after graduation, things will change a little. More of life is optional. It's up to you to decide where the bar will be raised to and what direction you will take. You are at the controls. It is you and your desire to contribute to the world that regulates what you do. Your potential is unlimited. Remember Bill Gates' words, "Don't compare yourself to anyone in this world." If you do so, you are only insulting yourself. We are not expected to know what you want to be or where you want to go. Make us guess and start. Do your best. You will make choices that are brilliant, and you will make mistakes. That is life. Don't let this make you upset or ashamed. Remember the expression, a ship is safest in the harbor, but that is not what ships are built for. So throw off the bow lines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, discover. This process, this experience, is molding you for a very special reason. It is to prepare you to leave your mark on the world, to leave it changed forever by your actions, maybe as an invention that has global implications, maybe as a teacher to achieve more than they thought and to ignite a whole new drive to success. It may be being a great partner or parent. Maybe you start a business that provides jobs for others. The point is not what it might turn out to be, but it is the impact it will leave. You have the tools, you have the desire. Discover what you are passionate about and don't ever look back. Today is about appreciating the past so that you can approach the future with the energy and enthusiasm it deserves. Each new day will be an opportunity to make your mark. As someone once said, the ultimate goal is to be better today than yesterday, with a plan to become even better tomorrow. Your accomplishment today is truly memorable and worthy of all the celebration that will follow. And the days that follow, remember that it is much and even more a new beginning as it is an end. Again, we as parents, family, and friends, and educators are so very proud of all of you. Knowing what you have accomplished and persevered through, there is no doubt that these Seahawks will fly high and far. On behalf of the Board of Education, I'd like to extend our sincerest congratulations to all and wish you the best of luck going forward.
Thank you, Mrs. Brogan. President Brogan, members of the Board of Education, the students before you have met the New York State requirements for high school graduation, and it is with great pride that I present to you the Cold Spring Harbor Class of 2022.
Gregor Acker. Max Adler. Kaylee Albers.
Brielle Ashlyn Amadeo. Isabella Ambriano. Jonathan Anderson. Isabel Apostolakos. Caleb Erneha. Megan Avalon. Emma Bauer. Lauren Bavaro.
Heather Rose Baxter. Sarah Grace Bolton. Andrew Brancato. Michael Bruderman Jr. Aiden Burdo. James Capozzo. Kimberly Ting Cardinale. Jonathan Carey. Camden Carswell. Shane Cashin. Caroline Chase.
Giovanna Teresa Ciampa. Caitlin Cohen. Nicholas Collins. Reed Cooper. Kira Olivia Cope. Kaylee Mary Corcoran. Jack Cornog. Caroline Lynn Coyne. Aiden DeGennaro. Michael Adam Degnan. Isabella Marie DiGregorio.
Jackson DeMarco. Carla Dimas Ramirez. Nicholas Discala. Rosie Doring. Francis Donahue. Deirdre Dunn. Ashley Arlene Ecker. Michael Kevin Edgar. Andrew Ioannidis.
Peter Ferrandino. Christina Focus. Kira Friedberg. Dana Friedlander. Keegan Gagnon. Gabrielle Guerra. Carolyn Gavalis. Garrett Gerasi. Luke Thomas Jarputo. Lena Gochin.
Melanie Golden. Scarlett Rose Haas. Anna Beatrice Hamill. Ava Hammond. Riley Haskell. Matthew Hastava. Maxwell Thomas Hawkinson. Beau Hodgson. Lily Hugis. Patrick Hickey.
Christian Insigna. Paola Jimbo. Lexi Johnson. Harry Jones. Kyle Junker. Lauren Elise Kenya. Andrew Cantor. Michael Cantor. Rafaela Katz. Michael Keschner.
Sarah Kiefer. Grace Kiernan. Sophie Labuda. Brady Leventhal. Fraser Lintott. Paige Lynch. Matthew Marino. Sarah Mazzi. Samantha McCormick. Michael McCoy. Megan McGloin.
Aiden McKean. Aaron McLear. Haley Mitchell. Drew Munn. Mackenzie Murray. Mary Namazi. Alexandra Nessie. Andrew Wang Nuihed. Alexander Nussbaum. Paul Arena. Slow down a little. No. Brian O'Rourke.
Theodore Chance Packer. Jennifer Papa. Justin Papaleo. Ava Marie Padlakis. Penelope Patsy. Angelina Padlakis. Jesse Fallon. Patrick Pisano. Jackson Polo. Kathleen Posilico.
Andrew Christopher Pulse. Jackson Pusey. Andrew Richmond. Hannah Bauer Richmond. Gabriella Rivadeneira. Caitlin Roberts. James Rogers. Melina Ross. Rebecca Schmitz. Casey Bell Schneider.
Jackie Sharma. Annabelle Shen. Sophia Shen. Riley Siegel. Sophia Smith. Ryan Spielberger. Cameron Starkins. Andrew Stern. Riley Steele. Lindsay Stimpel.
Charles Taukes. Lily Terry. Ryan Theobald. Ariana Theodorus. Paige Thompson. Ava Tai. Catherine Torrey. Thomas Nielsen Zacharides. Logan Vitagliano. Madison Wagner.
Isabel Waldorf. Jessica Wong. Edward Warren. Aiden Weaver. Alexander Weaver. Noah Weiss. Jada Wenger. Jillian Will. Spencer Will. George Yang.
Ladies and gentlemen, parents and friends, the class of 2022. At this time, I would like to thank our Board of Education, Ms. Girosh, and the District Office Administration for their work on behalf of the class of 2022 and all of the students in our district. I would also like to acknowledge the assistance provided today by the following groups: our Director of Facilities, Mr. Brian Graham, and our District Custodians and Grounds Crew, who pivoted on the drop of a hat yesterday to bring this ceremony indoors. Mr. Frank Papillo and our high school and district-wide security staff. All of our teachers who are here with us today. Ms. Tiger, Ms. Grosso, and our food services staff for providing refreshments. I'd like to thank again United States Vietnam veteran Sergeant Butch Jensen and Petty Officer Third Class John Dayton. And even though they're outside and we can't see them, I can see the ambulance, so thank you to the Cold Spring Harbor Fire Department for being here in case we needed them. To all of these individuals, we applaud your tireless efforts and endless dedication to our students and our entire school community, so thank you. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce two young ladies who have performed at pretty much, I would say, every school event since their arrival to Cold Spring Harbor. Please welcome Sophia and Annabelle Shen to perform Beethoven's Symphony No. 9, Chorale Movement 4, Ode to Joy. Thank you, Sophia and Annabelle. At this time, please welcome back to the podium our student governing president, Michael Keschner.
Good morning again. Fellow graduates, the tassel change signifies the completion of this important stage in our lives and allows us all to recognize our potential for a successful future. Graduates, please stand. At this time, please join us as we change our tassels from right to left. Congratulations, class of 2022.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, moms and dads, get those cameras ready. Ladies and gentlemen, parents and guardians, friends, family, staff, it is my pleasure to introduce for the first time the newest alumni of Cold Spring Harbor High School, the class of 2022.